Hello everyone, welcome to our next session geography class. So I hope all of you understood the first lesson field visit. Today's class we are going to start a new chapter number 2, location and extent. Are you remembering the skill what we learned in the last chapter? Observation, analysis, comparison, classification, evaluation, reading and drawing of map and graphs, and drawing conclusion and presentation, the last one, critical thinking. So these all skills we are going to apply in this coming lessons onwards, that means from second chapter onwards. In this chapter we are going to start India and Brazil. So about India, almost all the things you learn from your smaller classes, but Brazil we are going to learn now. So what all things we have to learn about India and Brazil? The location and extent of India and Brazil. So where India is located and same manner where Brazil is located. So you already learned about the location of India. India is located in the northern and eastern hemisphere. Where India is located? Northern and eastern hemisphere. And India, we know that our country is located in the Asian continent. And where it is located in the Asian continent? We learn that it is located in the southern part of Asia continent. So in the world, or if you are looking to the map or the world map or the globe, we can see the location of India. It is northern and eastern hemisphere. But if you are looking only in the Asian continent, India is located in the southern part. And the next one, it is the extent of India. What is the extent of India? That means the longitudinal extent of India. The extent from the east towards the west. East towards the west. That is the extent of India that I will show you with the help of map. And the next important thing, it is, what is the southernmost tip of India? It is Indira Point. Indira Point is the southernmost tip of India. And another question, what is the southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula? It is Kanyakumari. Don't make confusion that the southernmost point or the tip of India, it is Indira Point. It lies in Andaman and Nicobar Island. That means Indira Point. I will show these all things with the help of the map. And the next important thing we should know, that which is the northernmost state of India? Jammu and Kashmir. Which is the southernmost state of India? Tamil Nadu. Which is the easternmost state of India? Arunachal Pradesh. Which is the westernmost state of India? Gujarat. And we have to learn about the neighboring countries of India. Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Bangladesh and Myanmar. These all are the neighboring countries of India. So these all things we have to learn. Same manner, the states in India. How many states are there in India? What are the names of the state in India? And same manner, the national capital of India. What is the national capital of India? It is Delhi. Two islands, island groups are also there in India. One, it is lies in the Bay of Bengal, that is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The other one is located in the western part, that means in the Arabian Sea, it is Lakshadweep. So these all things you have to learn about India. These all we'll study once again with the help of India's map. Then the next one, it is of Brazil. So what all things we have studied about India, that almost all the points we have to learn about Brazil also. The major latitude which is passing through India, that is Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer is passing through the middle of India. It divides India into two parts, that is north and south. And India's southern part lies in the equatorial regions. India's southern part lies in the equatorial region. So these all things we have to study about India.
So dear students, here you can see the political map of India. It has shown the international boundary, state boundary and national capital. And here you can see that the states of India and its union territories that you have already learned. You should write in your notebooks the names of states and union territories of India. And here we start from the neighboring countries of India. They are Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar. And we can see that in the eastern and western part of India, and same manner the southern part also covered by the water bodies. In the western part Arabian Sea, southern part Indian Ocean, and in the eastern part Bay of Bengal. Along with that we can see in the eastern part the islands that they are Andaman and Nicobar Islands, which lies in the Bay of Bengal, and in the western part Lakshadweep Island, which lies in the Arabian Sea. Indira Point is the southernmost tip of India. You can see here it is located on 6° 45' north parallel in Andaman and Nicobar Island. The other important thing you should notice here, it is the major latitude which is passing through India. It is Tropic of Cancer, that is 23° 30' north. And you have to learn these all things for locating the map. And the national capital or the capital city of India, you can see here, it is New Delhi. So these all are the important points you should learn about India. Same manner the union territories also. And the next one, it is which is the northernmost state of India, that is Jammu and Kashmir, and easternmost state of India, Arunachal Pradesh, westernmost state of India is Gujarat, and southernmost state of India it is Tamil Nadu. The next one, I have already told about the most southernmost tip of India, it is Indira Point. Same manner, which is the southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula, it is Kanyakumari.
Next one, it is Brazil. The location of Brazil. The northern part of Brazil lies in the northern hemisphere, and the majority part lies in the southern hemisphere. And the speciality is two major latitudes are passing through Brazil. One, it is equator. Through the northern part of Brazil, equator is passing through. And through the southern part of Brazil, Tropic of Capricorn is passing through. So these all we should learn. So first question, which major latitude is passing through India? That is Tropic of Cancer. Which all major latitudes are passing through Brazil? Tropic of Capricorn and Equator. And these all latitudes are playing an important role to influence the climate of India and Brazil. Same manner, the flora and fauna of Brazil and India. And this Brazil lies in the South American continent. India is located in the Asian continent, and Brazil is located in the South American continent. And where it lies in South American continent? It lies in the Western Hemisphere, in the northern part of South American continent. And again here also we have to learn the extent of Brazil. I will show with the help of the map the extent. And the next one, it is which is the northernmost state of Brazil. Roraima is the northernmost state of Brazil. Paraiba is the easternmost state in Brazil. Acre is the westernmost state in Brazil, and Rio Grande do Sul is the southernmost state in Brazil. we learned that in India, west and east is covered by the water body, or we have the two coastal plains. One it is in the western part and another one it is in the eastern part. But in Brazil we can see that the ocean or the coastal plains are in the eastern part of the country. Then in the northern part, it is covered by the North Atlantic Ocean, and in southern part, it lies in the South Atlantic Ocean. Coastal plains you can see in Brazil, it is in the northeast and a southeast part of Brazil. And which all are the neighboring countries of Brazil? Uruguay, Argentina, Paraguay, Bolivia, Peru, Colombia, Venezuela, Guyana, Suriname, French Guyana. These all are the neighboring countries of Brazil. And Brasilia is the capital city of Brazil. It lies in the Goiás state. It lies in the Goiás state. So here we will study the map later. So you will get more idea about these states, extent, location, etc. Now we will study about Brazil's map.
So dear students, you can see the map of Brazil, political map of Brazil. Here same manner in India, it is also shows the capital of the nation. It is Brasilia, which lies in the Goiás. Then state boundaries and international boundaries. So here we'll start with the Brazilian states. So you please go through the Brasilia states. Just I will tell here, the northernmost state, it is Roraima. Easternmost Paraiba, southernmost Rio Grande do Sul, and the westernmost state it is Acre. And here it's the latitudinal and longitudinal distance 5° 15' north to 33° 45' south latitudes, and between 234° 45' west to 73° 48' west longitude. And the next one, if you are looking into this map, we can understand Brazil has different neighboring countries, such as if you are starting from the southern part, Uruguay, Argentina, Paraguay, Bolivia, Peru, Colombia, Venezuela, Guyana, Suriname, French Guyana are the neighboring countries of Brazil. And here we can see the water body is covered by the eastern part of Brazil, that is North Atlantic Ocean and a South Atlantic Ocean. And through this Brazil, we can see that two major latitudes are passing through. One, it is equator, which is passing through the northern part of Brazil. Same manner, the Tropic of Capricorn, 23° 30' south, which is passing through the southern part of Brazil. And the Brazil is located in the northern and southern hemispheres, and it is located in the South American continent. So these all are the important points you should know, and you should know to locate in Brazil's map. So please learn well the states, neighboring countries, equator, through which all states equator is passing through which all states Tropic of Capricorn is passing through, and the water body, it is only covered by the eastern part of Brazil. There are no water bodies or like this oceans are in the north or the western part of the Brazil. So please learn well the longitudinal and latitudinal extents, states, neighboring countries, water bodies and major latitudes which are passing through the Brazil.
So I hope all of you understood well. So here you have to learn the neighboring countries and the total number of the states, union territories and water bodies, etc. of India and Brazil. Next small topic, it is historical background of India. We already learned the historical background of India from lower classes in history subject. So I hope all are remembering that one. What is history of India? That means we got freedom in the year 1947. Which month? August. Which date? 15th. From who we got? That means from the Britishers. And after independence also, India faced lot of problems such as famine-like situation. It is not famine, but like that situation. That means we learned that India's major problems, they are poverty and unemployment. Poverty and unemployment. Before we were getting freedom, India faced famine. But after independence, famine we can't tell, but famine-like situations like poverty. Then what is the reason of the poverty? Unemployment is the reason. And three wars were the main problems in our India's economic development is very fast. So we are considering that India is a developing country. And another speciality of India, it is known as young country. India is known as young country. So we have learnt in the last, that means in the smaller classes also, when we learned about population, you learned that those who are in age group between 15 to 59 are more. That means the number of youths are more in our country. So because of that, we can tell the productive population is more. Productive population means in this category or this age group, we can see that more people, that means almost all are productive in the sense they all are working, or working population is more in India. Then more than the number of the children, same manner more than the number of aged people, the working population is more in India. That means the number of youths are more in India. So India is known as young country. So because of that, India is developing, or its economical field, social field, every fields India is developing. So India is known as a developing country also. You may be learned that it is almost all the countries are categorized into three groups. One, it is developed. Second one, developing. Third one, underdeveloped. So among these three, India is a developing country. So the next one, it is of historical background of Brazil. So same like India, we are now comparing. That means same like India, Brazil also was under the colonial rulers. So Brazil was under the Portuguese rulers, and it got independence in the year 1822. So before India, Brazil got independence. But what happened later? From 1930 to 1985, it was under the most popular military government. That means more than a half century, it was under the military rule. It has overcome some global financial difficulties in the late 20th century. And now we can see that Brazil's economic development is more than India, and it is contributing a lot to the economic growth. And it has a good market in the future also. So these all are the historical background of Brazil. So when we are comparing both India and Brazil, what are things we can understand? That means both countries were under the rule of the other countries or the foreign countries, and later both got independence, and now both are like developing, but Brazil's economic development is more than India. And another important thing, it is, I already explained that India is known as the young country. Same manner, what are things we know about India and Brazil? India is the second largest populated country in the world. India is famous for its spices. Brazil is famous for its coffee product. So I hope all of you understood. And again, one extra question, like regarding India, why India is known as a young country. Same manner, you can expect one question like, Brazil is known as the coffee port of the world because it is producing more coffee, and for near about 40% of coffee is contributing from the Brazil. So it is also known as the coffee port of the world. So you have to read the textbook well, and point out all the important points and do the map study well. So thank you.